Yeah, we're doing the sound first, then start speaking.
choreography because it is distracting to the performers and those around you. Also, food and drinks are not permitted inside the auditorium. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the department leader and theater instructor for the Academy of the Arts, Mr. Michael Despars.
I would like to take a moment to recognize the Gabrielino Band of Mission Indians, also known as the Kiz Nation, on whose sacred ground we're gathering tonight. They are the past, present, and future caretakers of this land. Welcome to the show. Because they came to campus at 8 o'clock this morning, looked around, saw our newly renovated MSA building, walked around the campus, and were just, wow, my school looks great. And why didn't we have all these things when I was here? And then we got to work at 9 o'clock. It was our downbeat for our rehearsal. We worked until noon. We had lunch served by our culinary academy, again, to highlight the things that our school offers. Our Choral Booster Club has been wonderful at being kind of the producers of this and hosts for this. And our own students have helped out during the day as well. And then we came in here and figured out, okay, So again, it's not a concert, it's a time to renew and to share. And so I hope the music that they share, the whole agenda, that some soloists and their guests, you'll get something about that.
So now I changed it to two oxes.
Thank you.
it is not working.
And many of them sent in a number of themes for the composer, the Los Angeles composer, Morten Lauridsen. Many of them were probably more than we could have accomplished in one day. But I also wanted in this concert that I've been going in my mind, as I told them earlier today, for several years. I wanted the text of Sure on This Shining Night. So I finally narrowed it down to three different composers' settings.
Yeah, that's true.
And I kept changing those out and looking and sitting down and playing through them. And finally I decided, okay, a lot of them wanted to do some music by Morten Lauridsen. One of these is his edition, so this is Morten Lauridsen's arrangement of Sure on This Shining Night.
Yeah. And I can't do anything about it right now. Because the more I mess with it, the difference is greater.
Thank you.
now it's going to be protected.
Treading carefully here. Okay. Your program lists a number of things, but it also at the bottom says that we are going to have a number of solos as well, and they will be coming up soon. But first, we have a group with us that is representing a larger group. They are representing the Orange Empire Chorus, which is Fullerton's barbershop chorus. They have been in existence for many, many years. They provide a wonderful opportunity for men to gather to sing every Tuesday night in our choir room, and we are so pleased to be able to host them every Tuesday night for that. And in turn, they do a lot of activities around town. They raise a lot of money, and they give it all back to the music programs in our schools. So for all of the years of my being here, and that there has been a wonderful relationship with them, I felt we must have some representation of them on this concert tonight. So we have a quartet from them, and they're going to come out on the stage now, and they will do what quartets do, is they will introduce themselves, they will tell you what they're going to say, and then they will just entertain you wonderfully. Featuring some soloists. The One thing, all these, several things these soloists have in common. First of all, they were all of you and our students that are sitting down here at one point. And so they came here, many of them chose Fullerton High School for this program, and they were all part of our choirs. They were also part of something else. They were part of our Fullerton Vocal Studio, which when we first started that over 2 decades ago, there were no other schools around who offered a vocal studio where students could get one-on-one vocal training in conjunction with the choral program. We set the standard, we created it, and it's now something that's common in many schools with very strong programs. But it started here. Each of the students will introduce themselves, and they will tell you a little bit about what their, first I said, introduce yourself and say your graduation year. That did not meet with very good, it's not happening. So, they will introduce themselves, and they'll tell you where they went in their lives after Fullerton Union High School. You'll see some commonalities on some of them, and, but one, commonality is that within the Fullerton Union Vocal Studio, their teacher, Timothy McDougall, for all five of these, he was their first voice teacher, and in some cases, that instruction lasted all the way through graduate school for them. And so when I hear them sing, I hear his voice, and I hear him. So we're gonna hear some more of him sing.
Mr. Hedgecock taught us how to be not just a musician, but how to be a human being, how a little bit of personal responsibility, preparation, hard work is all you really need. And it's everything you need to have true cooperation. And he taught us, above all, hope, and how to speak for those who whose voice has been taken from them. And for that, I thank you. Peace.
I went on to college and get my bachelor's at Cal State Long Beach. I got it in music performance. And I am now working professionally in the choral and theatrical world here in Los Angeles and in New York and in Tokyo, Japan. I feel very lucky to be on the stage, and I'm very grateful for the things I learned here from both Scott and Tim. Today I will be singing Love to Me from the Light of the Piazza.
Olivia Hernandez. I graduated from Fullerton Union High School Academy of the Arts, and I went on to get my BFA in musical theater at the University of Michigan. I am now a professional actor. I live in New York City. I'm actually leaving on Tuesday to go do Guys and Dolls at the Gawthrop Theater in Minneapolis. I'm playing Sarah Brown. Very excited. In 2016, I got married, and Scott was my officiant. And in case anyone's looking for a wedding officiant, he's really, really good at that, too. And, you know, we chose him because we knew that there would be some really special moments, aside from the fact that he's great at speaking. I just knew that it would be the right feeling, and we told him all the readings that we wanted in our wedding, and he said, well, if you don't mind, I'm gonna probably add something a little special, you know, something that you don't know about. And I was like, well, of course. And so the morning of my wedding, he was sitting out on the veranda where we were going to be married later that day, and he was looking up into the sky, and he saw these birds flying in formation. And he remembered a song that I sang my senior year of high school here. And so he surprised me and inserted the text of this song into my wedding ceremony. This song is Migratory Bee by Adam Gettle. And I'm so sorry, but before I sing it, I also want to give a major thanks to Anthony Lopez. It's been really wonderful the times I've been able to come back and sing here to have such a fantastic accompanist at a high school.
in our history here. We had a jazz choir, vocal jazz choir, and it was directed by my then colleague, Jill DeWeese, who was on staff here with us. And when this event was being planned, she said, can I talk to some of the jazz kids to come back as well? We'll be coming back in this, and can we do a jazz number for you? And of course, the answer was, yeah. You know, that'd be cool. Mrs. DeWeese now is the choral director at Buena Park High School, so the students there are getting her expertise, especially in the jazz idiom, and then we're going to continue to see lots of wonderful things happening there with them. But I just want to thank her for wanting to be part of this, and also for these students to bring back some jazz, and also just personally to Jill for teaching me how to snap on two. So please enjoy this jazz presentation. Ha ha ha!
Hello, everyone. My name is David Blair. I'm a graduate of 2003 under the tutelage of Timothy McDougall and then the direction of Scott Hedgecock. I've gone on to perform in some of the world's greatest opera houses. I worked for Opera Pacific for a number of years, Long Beach Opera. I worked at Carnegie Hall. And just so you guys all know, it's so important to support the arts, because whatever we take from our experience in the arts, our experience with amazing people like Scott Hedgecock, we take on and we put those into whatever careers we go into in the future. So for the young people in the front who are still currently in school, cherish these moments, cherish the experience you're having with these instructors, because oftentimes you take them for granted, and it's only, you know, years later that you start to realize what an impact and legacy that that has made on your life. So, thank you. I will be singing "Till I Hear You Sing" from Love Never Dies.
Year old boys teacher, so it's pretty cool that some of my students are here.
I had, you know, went on tour, did things. About 9 years ago, I found myself back in Fullerton and got back in touch with Scott. We never lost touch, of course, but I started really being a part of this school again, and I've been teaching voice here for 9 years. Scott has been... Scott has been such a mentor to me in so many ways. I remember one of my first recitals that I had coming back, it was probably 2011 or 12 or so, I gave like a terrible speech at the recital in front of parents. It was really bad. And I said to Scott, how do you get up in front of people and do this? He's so good at his job and creating programs and speaking in front of people. And he said, you'll get better. And so years of just watching him create and organize and inspire has been really wonderful for me to watch. I'm so grateful to have been a part of this school. The song I'm singing today is Ohio 1904. It's a song that kind of came to me a couple of years ago. I sang it in my master's recital, so I thought I'd do it again.
Thank you.
You know, when two musicians get together and live their life together, that can be scary. Not to tell you it's not a good thing, but sometimes. But Tim and I used to joke that as individuals we were okay, but together we made a pretty decent human being. And we like to share music, we like to share things we found.
It's
time, years ago, I said, I just look at this recording, somebody doing this song, and it's just so fantastic. I hope when I die, somebody will sing this in my funeral. And he played it, and it was, much maybe the music.
Yeah, I guess what?
And it was a solo version, and he just, and of course, I said, well, there's got to be a choral arrangement of it. He kind of rolled his eyes. And I found the arrangement. And so over the years, when I felt it was a group that was worthy of this piece, and that little bit of its personal part to me, we would do it. And I knew that this year's group, this would pretty much be our theme song for the year. We would start the year out with. Order.
Harmony.
Coming out of there, then you don't get anything from the video set. And for the first like four choral numbers, he didn't want anything coming out of the speakers. And I totally forgot about that. So I routed you back to an auxiliary. So hopefully you got more of it later on.
I did.
Okay.
I did. It started like the levels were crazy high later, but I was doing a four channel, so I was also recording from these speakers.
Okay,
so
cool.
Whatever is usable, I'll use. Whatever is not, I picked up as well.
Yeah.
So
there's like a ton of stuff that didn't want, and then he wanted, and then I was like, I come here, I'm part time, so
yeah, you're like,
I don't know perfectly.
Yeah, for sure, dude. No worries, man. I got it. It worked out.
Yeah, it's the most part.
Thank you.
No problem.
Tons. Yeah, a lot of people.